But then, guys, welcome back.
TFT, the food troll, and we are back with another raw and unedited food review. Now, before we crack on with our review, I just want to say to all of you guys, the food troll family, thank you, thank you, thank you, and congratulations. The channel has hit the 5k mark. Also, a special thank you to my daughter behind the camera and Ali, who started off this venture with me. When we first started, people thought it was a bit of a laugh. We had a few people taking the mic. Ziggy, what are you doing at your age? Reviewing food, getting on the camera. But you know what? Just over a year now, and I tell you what, it's been an emotional ride. We've had some good times, we've had some bad times as well. But you know what? You are the guys that matter, and I tell you why. I could be reviewing Gordon Ramsay's bloody pie and mash in his kitchen. It's all irrelevant until you guys watch. When you guys watch it, that's when it becomes relevant. If you guys aren't watching, it don't mean shit. Pardon my French. But anyway, formalities are done. We have come to Sunderland, Pennywell Industrial Estate, trying out a place called CHOM. I like that name, CHOM. Pennywell Industrial Estate, show them around with it, have a look. It's just an industrial estate. You've got Asda down there, you've got an Iceland, you've got a betting shop as well, you got barbers, Goldilocks. So it's not Indian takeaway you're gonna find on the high street, it's actually in industrial area. 5:30 till 11, let's quickly look at the menu. There we go. I think that's enough talking done. Let's get stuck into the food. A lot of you have been saying, food troll, curry, curry, curry. So here we are. We're gonna be trying out one of their curries. Sauces, you've got a naan. The chef said he's chucked some of these special spicy chips in. He said, I want the food troll to try them. So them are on the house. He never charged me for them. Right, we got ourselves. Excuse me, let's get this in here. Let's start off. We got ourselves the lamb karahi. Have a look at this. Yep. Hey. The lamb karahi cost us £7.50. We also got ourselves a naan bread, £2 for the naan bread. Now then, for those of you who want to know how to eat a curry with a chapati, when we first started our channel, I did a little video. Get on my channel, check it out. But I'm going to show you once again. There's your naan bread. Let's break the naan bread up. Oops, put that back here. Now then, naan looks a bit floury, to be honest with you. I'm not sure whether that's cooked all the way through. Let's dip it in the lamb. Scoop it up. Smells nice. Plenty of spices, plenty of herbs coming through. Wow. I'll take back what I said about the naan bread. Nice, fluffy naan bread. The lamb, I only got a bit of the sauce there. Let's try a bit of meat. I think that's a piece of lamb there. You can see the herbs and spices in there as well. This lamb karahi has been made in like spices and yogurt as well. It's been pan fried, called the lamb karahi. Actually, let's see if we can find another piece of lamb. There we are. Let's get a big piece of lamb in. A lot of you say to me, food troll, stop licking your fingers. But what am I supposed to do? That lamb It's soft. It's tender. Works well with that naan bread. The spices, he said to me, do you want it too spicy? I went, keep it medium. Spices are just right. I'll tell you why, it's a kindly big portion as well. For £7.50, there is a lot of curry in there. You got your peppers, you got your onions. I just wish you could smell this thing. Look at the sauce and spices and that. We'll get it in the sun, eh? Wow. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. I'm gonna go and get some tissue.
Have you got some tissue?
The guy wanted to stand and talk. I told him, I said, it's a one take review. I need to get back. Right, lamb karahi. I've been impressed with that rida. The meat, the spices, the herbs, everything absolutely amazing. And for £7.50, that's a very, very reasonable price. Naan bread, initially I did think it was a bit floury, but it's got a good quality taste to that. I like the way that's been done. Works well with that lamb karahi. Now, he wanted me to try these, the special spicy chips. Let's have a look. Oh, they look like potato wedges. You know what, he forgot to give me a fork, but I'm not going to go back in and get a fork. Let's get our hands dirty. Let's have a look at this here. Get it in the sun. Wow, that's hot on my fingers. Wow, that's really hot. Nice spice on them, really medium-ish, not too spicy. Got a nice masala taste. I would say they're more masala chips than they are spicy chips. See, still nice and hot. They've got, you chucked some onions in. You got some herbs in there as well. Let's have a good look at that. They are a bit thick though. I would have preferred them to be maybe be a bit thin cut, like this one. I prefer that size to that size. Let's try this one. It's got an onion on it. See, that's better. These here, they're like bloody roast potatoes, the size of them. Too much potato content in them. So maybe cut down on them, make them a bit smaller. But you know what, Chom Chom? Thank you for them. It was good that you'd think of me and give me them on the house, right? I've come to this place, I fancied a pizza as well. So I thought, I've come to get a takeaway, I've come to get a curry, let's try one of their Indian pizzas. Let's have a look. It is the Balti special. Actually, let's get this one here. You got lamb mince, chicken tikka, quite a few other things going as well, peppers, herbs. Let's have a look, cheese pull. Yes, it's happening, it's happening, it's happening. Now then, cliffhanger test. I'm impressed with that actually. Just have a look at the base as well. I'll give you a 360. You can see that sauce dripping off the base as well. Can you see it? Tell you what, it looks absolutely fantastic. And you know what? It tastes better than it looks. Absolutely amazing. Loads of flavors coming through there. The mince, the chicken tikka, the curry sauce drenched at the bottom there as well. Nice cheese. I like the way they've done this as well. Not too overpowering with them herbs. Herbs are just right. And the base, it's a thin base, but it's nice. It's nice and fluffy. It's not too crispy. It's got a nice fluffy texture to it. Cooked well. This is a special thing, because it's very hard to get a decent pizza from people who specialize in Indian curry houses. So CHOM CHOM, well done for that. I'm liking the way you did that pizza. Now, a bit into a chili there. Ah, that was a green chili there. There's another one. Small but deadly. Ho-ho. Now, sauces. Garlic, chili. Weather's nice as well, innit? Sun is shining. It's gonna be a great summer, guys. It's gonna be a great summer. There's gonna be some cracking reviews coming on this channel. Let's try the garlic first. A bit runny. Actually, very runny. Not as creamy as what I thought it might be. Wow. That tastes absolutely sublime. I'm gonna get a good dip of garlic in there. Have a look. Oh, you know what? This pizza spicy. It's beginning to kick now. Let's get rid of that. Dip it in. That's what I'm talking about, lads. That's what I'm talking about. Absolutely amazing. Really, really nice, strong taste of garlic. I know it's not creamy, but it's got a really good kick. Right, chili. Have a look at this. Whoa, look at them. You can see them little red dots in there, which tells me that this is gonna be dangerous. It's gonna be a danger one, this one. But hey ho, let's do this food troll. You know what? Started off really cool, really refreshing. Really cool. Probably one of the coolest, refreshing chili sauce starts I've had on the channel. And right at the end, look at the texture on that. If you love your chili sauce, you're gonna absolutely love this. You know what? The sacrifices I make for you guys at home by doing that. Guys, that was hot. Now then, lamb karahi, absolutely amazing. Naan bread, loved it. Wasn't keen on the spicy chips, too thick. If you're gonna call them chips, let's cut them into chips and not into bloody jacket potatoes. They're like the size of them, they're like that. Too big. Pizza, fantastic, very impressed. One of the best Indian pizzas I've tried. I tried an Indian pizza at 370 in CHOM. If you haven't seen that one, you can see that on the channel as well. But quite possibly one of the best Indian pizzas I've tried on the channel. Washing it down with a Fanta lemon. Garlic and chili, as well. Hey there, guys, you alright? Garlic and chili, as always, is present for the review. Now then, one more thing to do, and that is give CHOM CHOM, the guy smiling in there, he's listening in, CHOM CHOM, Indian and Pizzeria, the score. It's a 5,000 special today. We've gone to 5,000 subscribers. And I tell you what, keep watching, keep subscribing. And I really, really hope that we can continue bringing you the good content and honest reviews. CHOM CHOM, it's a special day for us today. It's a special review. And the food troll today is gonna be giving you a massive, respectable 8.9. Had them spicy chips, been thin cut, you will have got yourselves into the nines. But 8.9 is still a fantastic, brilliant score, on the food troll. One more thing to say, well, two more things to say. One thing is, keep watching the channel, and I want to say once again, thank you to you guys. I love you all. You are now officially part of the food troll family. You know what I mean? The TFT family. You become my members, you become my loved ones. Last but not least, one message to CHOM CHOM Indian Pizzeria. You guys, on a fantastic, beautiful, sunny evening, 10 past 6, have officially been food troll certified, and I shall see you guys for the next one.